Hello guys, welcome back to our channel. This video is all about 9 books that have made me a better person. As someone who is a bit obsessed with getting the best out of herself, and helping others get the best out of themselves too, books are my best friend. I love the minds I get access to and the light bulb moments that come from someone presenting a thought or idea in a way that changes my life. And there have been many life-changing moments over the past 5 to 6 years, I can tell you. Okay, wait, before start this video, kindly subscribe to our channel. Okay, let's get into the video. The Little Book of Anxiety. All my life I've been told you worry too much. Stop worrying so much. Like it's a tap I can turn off. Reading Carrie's book gave me the proper name for that constant nagging feeling that has been with me for as long as I can remember. And having a proper name for that feeling gave me the confidence I needed to have conversations with medical professionals that I'd never have had otherwise. With the help of those medical professionals, I now know how to manage this thing better. I can't even begin to describe what a gift that has been to my life. The Gifts of Imperfection. I was rather late to the party with this one. Any number of people had told me I should read it, but it wasn't until a friend actually sent me her copy earlier this year that I did. And wow, I basically highlighted the entire book. As the book's name suggests, it tackles perfectionism. It showcases the amazing connections that come from allowing yourself to be imperfect and vulnerable. And most importantly, it gave me a blueprint for recognizing where and when I need to be kinder to myself. Life in Half a Second. As you can imagine, I've read a few self-help books in my time. And I really didn't think I had much more to learn from the genre. So Matthew's book, which had been sent to me, sat on my bedside table for months until I'd gotten through a rather large fiction backlog. Now I consider myself a pretty self-motivated and driven person, yet this book lit a fire underneath me. It really firmed up the way I approach the goals I have for myself, but also helped me clarify what's really important, and ensured that if I was spending time and energy chasing something, it was the right thing. Essentialism. Speaking of clarifying what's important, I only read this book last month, but know I will return to it again and again. It puts into words all the philosophies I have about white space and the importance of knowing what you want from life, philosophies that live in my head, but I find hard to articulate. It shows very clearly that you cannot prioritize things in your life if you don't actually know what's important to you. It shows you the value of focus. I read this book and thought to myself, how has this book not been written before? The Happiness Project. I read this book around the time when I was at my lowest point ever, and it was nothing like I expected. I thought it would be your typically American peppy, if you think it, you can do it type stuff, so not sure why I actually bought it, but bought it I did, and I immediately fell in love with the practical and methodical way Gretchen tackled her happiness project. I loved how she mixed self-reflection with pragmatism. I loved how honest she was about her own shortcomings. It was so nice to see that happiness doesn't just happen to people. It is actually something we have to work for. I was ready to do the work, and Gretchen showed me how. Predictably Irrational. This is one for all the control freaks out there. I like understanding my fellow human beings. If I understand someone's motivations and why they're behaving a certain way, it makes me a nicer person because I am better able to control my reactions to their behavior. Dan's book, which is really well written and easy to understand, has helped immeasurably with this. Tiny Beautiful Things. Cheryl Strayed has packed a lot of living into her life. And that considerable life experience means she is uniquely placed to give people advice about pretty much anything. Her command of the written word means she is able to do so in an absolutely exquisite way. So this book paralyzed me a little because I will never be able to write like her. But it also gave me a better understanding of certain things I will never come across myself, and has opened my mind considerably. The Power of Habit. I don't have a lot of time to read long books with relatively small print these days. But I am fascinated by habits, having written about them in Your Best Year Ever, and was keen to learn more. So I settled into slog through this book and was thrilled to find that I didn't have to slog at all. This book is a perfect example of how powerful storytelling is when it comes to spreading a message and sharing knowledge. Everything I learned from it, I was able to put into action almost immediately. The section on the link between cravings and habits was hugely fascinating and enlightening, and I've been able to apply those learnings to just about every area of my life already. Quiet. The Power of Introverts. If you're an introvert, and you've spent your whole life subtly being told by the world that you're very uncool and in order to be accepted you need to be more extroverted, then this book will be the same revelation for you that it was for me. I cannot adequately articulate how much it changed the way I looked at myself, but I did try here. If you're an extrovert and you're thinking, what even? Please read this book. It will help you understand your introvert friends so much better. And trust me when I tell you, they'd love you to understand them better. I hope you enjoyed this video. Share your thoughts in the comment section. Have a great day. Thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe. Follow me on Instagram, link in the description. Stay connected. #learn something. Bye.